Hello and welcome. My name is Jeff Zellin. I'm the Engineering Group Manager for Advanced Audio Products here at Panasonic Automotive Systems. I'm here today to talk to you about some novel EV solutions we have. Joining me today is Tony Thompson. Tony, why don't you take a second and introduce yourself?
Sure, no problem. Thanks for having me. I'm a staff acoustics engineer. I've been working at Panasonic for about 6 years, and there's been a number of projects that I've worked on over the years, various demos, and I've had my hands in system design, so I've done a lot of electronic stuff and DSP as well as acoustics, so glad to be here.
So the technology we're talking about today is EV audio solutions, and we got involved with EV audio solutions primarily because we've seen a big market shift. There's a lot of interest in EV products overall, and we decided it was time to really start tailoring our products to support EVs going forward. We know the future of EVs is here. We know by 2030, many of the municipalities have enforced a 2030 mandate for EV vehicles in market. So we set out to do some novel and interesting things in order to achieve that kind of EV dream for Panasonic. Overall, we really wanted to focus on purely EV solutions. These solutions can work in other vehicles, but we really wanted to focus on the real pattern of delivering EV vehicles going forward. Overall, Panasonic has been a leader in the audio space. We have a long history of premium audio solutions, technology solutions around ANC, noise cancellation, engine noise generation. Our audio products are pretty much in all the vehicles in the market that you can see most of the time. Tony, why don't you talk a little bit about what we decided to do and what we wanted to accomplish with this EV project?
Right. So a traditional base grade audio system that we'll see in vehicles usually has like a 4 or 6 speaker system. And what we were thinking was, how could we slim that down? How could we reduce the weight? How could we improve efficiency? And overall, how could we preserve the sound quality by limiting and potentially maneuvering some of the speakers in different locations to get the best sound experience we possibly could for the EV market? So we started off by creating a surrogate system that we could, you know, do some initial tests. And we pared this down to the point where we could reduce the number of speakers in the vehicle by half, and essentially reducing the weight by more than half, considering that we were taking the speakers out of the doors and moving them into more central locations. We also took the opportunity to refine a method that we had been using all along with some other vehicles, but we have a proprietary method of locating the speakers in an appropriate position that optimizes their location. And all of this together ended up yielding a fairly surprising experience for us. I think the sound quality of some of the demos that we had created from our experiences here really excited us, as we were able to not only to achieve the success with the metrics that we set out to achieve, but so which were, you know, efficiency, weight, and power consumption, but we were also able to maintain, if not improve upon, a sound quality of a traditional base grade system. So the idea here is that we were starting with a base grade system, and this was something that could potentially be modular, and we could add to it and have a scalable system that worked all the way from base grade audio system, which we've proven out, all the way up through a premium experience.
So Tony, you know, you mentioned things like space, weight, power. Those are really traditional systems level measurements, right? A classic automaker would look at space, weight, power, cost as the critical metrics for how you design for a vehicle. You want to reduce space, you want to reduce the weight, obviously lower cost and lower power. I think part of the magic of what we were able to accomplish with the system was really driving down all of those key metrics for the customer. We think that's really impactful though in the EV space. A lot of opportunity to lower weight and power really improves our mileage. So Tony, when we remove speakers from the door, what kind of impact does that have on the system overall?
Right, it has three big factors that we're looking at. One is the reduction of weight, and that's the big one. When we get the doors free of speakers, we're also removing harnesses or any bracketing that might be there to hold the large 6x9s or 6.5-inch speakers that are in a traditional base grade system. We're reducing our complexity. and we're getting the speakers away from the doors and in more optimal locations. And the third thing that I want to speak to is the reduction in harmonic distortion. So one of the problems of having a speaker mounted in a door, a large speaker that is a bass-producing speaker, is that there are panel resonances. This leads directly to harmonic distortion, and we're removing that problem when we remove the speaker from the door.
So we talked a little bit about some of the savings we had for power usage, and you know, we talked a little bit about the weight, but is it safe to say, like in the doors, when we reduce the weight that's out in the door, we're also reducing some of the structures in those doors, as well as reducing some of the reinforcement that would be necessary for the hinges to hold that heavier door up. And we've also then taken care of some problems for warranty issues for our customers. A lot of times those door speakers create challenges around warranty returns, squeak, rattle, noise issues that we've then all but eliminated for the customer in those areas. It's a pretty novel approach and it's pretty exciting.
Yeah, that's correct. Yeah, you mentioned something about the buzz and the hum that you're normally hearing in door speakers. And that's a real problem. There's always going to be door vibrations with traditional systems that, you know, it's inevitable. When you have a large speaker, a 6x9 or a 6.5 inch speaker that's, you know, that's putting out some substantial bass, you're going to get rattles no matter what. That's just an inevitable issue that, you know, most manufacturers run into. And by removing the speakers from the doors and lessening the size, we're able to circumvent that issue.
So with a traditional entry level or a base grade system, you have door speakers both in the front and the rear. And you know, part of our concept was let's remove all door speakers, which included the rear speakers. Do we see any kind of impact on the performance in the rear seat by not having speakers in those doors?
No, not really. There's an interesting phenomenon. When you're sitting in the back seat of a traditional system, you have usually one optimal tuning position, which is the driver position and sometimes the passenger in the front row. And these systems that exist right now are not optimized for the back row. But in this case, we were able to, by removing the speakers in the back, we were able to maneuver around a situation that is known as superposition. So you have, you know, the front door speakers are fighting with the rear door speakers. The time alignment works for the front row, but not for the back row. So you end up with some strange, the speakers are stepping on one another in a traditional system. Whereas since we're using fewer speakers in our EV system, we don't have that issue. We're able to utilize our location benefit. And what we're seeing is that the frequency response in the front row and the back row is very similar, and you also likewise get similar distortion measurements in front and back. And I'll also add that by locating the woofer in the appropriate location, that the cabin, the excitation of the bass in the cabin seems to couple well in the back seat, in the back row as well.
It all sounds a little bit like magic. It's almost as if someone should have discovered this before. You know, I know this seems like we've got this, you know, great innovation, but there's so much excitement around what we've done from everybody seeing this product demo. They are completely blown away. I think it speaks a lot to our expertise in audio and acoustics, our ability to identify optimizations within the acoustic environment in the cabin, our ability to identify the right speakers for the right locations, identifying those perfect locations within the cabin, and the technologies that couple with it really allow us that opportunity to create a hyper-efficient design with all of these key qualities nailed, right? We've reduced the amount of space. Those doors are now freed up for people to, in the design studio side, do more creative things, like put in pockets for people to put purses or other type of traveling things that are required for the door pocket. You know, we've reduced the overall power consumption. We've seen results that show half the power use. We're lowering the weight of the system, which ultimately means you're not having to push around so much weight with the EV engine. So all of these hidden costs within that system are really driving the efficiency goal. The EV systems that we design for the future all have to be hyper-focused on these key concepts of space, weight, power, without driving a ton of cost into the system. We think novel solutions like this really get it done.
Yeah, I think it's also important to note that this was an intentional design, right? So it wasn't any one technology, I think, that put us over the top. It was an aggregate sum of a lot of different things that we had learned over the years that we were able to put together into a really optimized, very sleek system.
And Tony, thank you very much for coming together with me today to talk about this. It's a pretty exciting thing for Panasonic. Our audio team here in North America collaborates with our partners around the world. We've got this wonderful global footprint where we support both our base products, but then we also have premium products throughout the world. And we support different premium level brands like Klipsch Premium Audio, ELS, and Fender. And a product like this can really scale up to some of these premium levels.
Yes, it certainly could. You know, we're starting with the base grade system that really gives us a platform on which to grow. Now, one of the other interesting design aspects of this system is that once we get the base grade audio system components in place, they don't change. What we're doing from this point on is we're stacking in a modular sense. What a mid-grade or a high mid-grade, what an entry-level premium system or a high premium system would be, just by adding speakers to the existing speakers that were there for the grade below it.
Yeah, it's pretty exciting. I'm pretty happy to share this with all of you. I want to thank everybody for tuning in to listen to us talk about this exciting product we have in the EV market. And Tony, thanks again for sharing your knowledge with us. And I look forward to talking to you again another time.
Likewise. Thanks for having me.